I was just going to give you just a little bit of history that came to mind when we're harvesting this field. And this field, which we call the Bracken, was the reason why we call it the Bracken was back in 69 is when we, actually my dad and my uncle had this, was virgin sod, and so they decided to break it. It was about 160 acres. So when you broke virgin sod out here in this Golden Triangle of Montana, glaciers left a lot of rocks. So you would rip it with spikes, and then try to cut the sod in ribbons, and then you would have an old rock picker that you would take and try to pick the big rocks off so you could drive the tractor across it, and then you'd rip it another direction, do it again, and finally you got it worked down where the sod was somewhat worked out. Then you had to go to hand picking because there were so many rocks that were the size of basketball on down to like your fist. So the only way you could do it was hand picking. And all this country through all the years before they got mechanized rock pickers, all of it was hand picked. You know, they used to take flat pieces of boilerplate, if they could find something like that, and drag it onto the field first with horses. And then they would use vehicles, an old pickup or tractors, roll the rocks on, drag it off to the edge of the field, roll it back off, go back and load them up again. Well, we used an old 55 Chevy truck, about 14 foot, with wood sides and a wood box that had been built for that purpose. And so we rounded up a bunch of our friends. I was probably junior high, and we went rock picking. We thought that was fun, and also we were getting paid. I can't remember what it would have been, probably a couple dollars a day or $3 or $4. I'm not sure back then. But the fun didn't only lasted so long. We tried to do different kind of games to try to help pass the time and the effort, like finding a place on the truck to try to see if we could get a rock to stay. Well, the next day they built a metal cage for the window because it got cracked, the rear window of the truck. So anyway, I remember that, and it was a number of days out here, and just, I think there was probably somewhere around 150 loads of the truck that was hand-picked. But it's really nice now because hand-picking takes all those small rocks off. So anyway, when I farm this, I think back about that time when we were young and energetic and didn't think it through on the effort. Look what we have here. I don't think that this bucket goes on that loader. Hey, I rock, don't I?
I just happened to find something that I haven't seen in many years. And I'll give you a hint. What's something that has 18 toes? Well, toes and fingers. Salamander. These guys are absolutely incredible. Somehow, they survive in this really tough environment. They're super harmless. In fact, I don't even think they have teeth. Pretty cool. He's a pretty chill little dude. Don't fall. Fell in my jeans, but caught us a little critter. That's pretty cool though. Thought I'd share. Sweet. We got a water pump for the John Deere. Our John Deere tractor has been overheating. And we thought, well, maybe it's the thermostats. We took them out. Well, maybe it's the radiators getting plugged. And we flushed it and tried to clean it out. But it was still getting hot. And we could have just changed the water pump right at first, but you kind of want to diagnose the other simple things before you just throw almost $300 in water pumps. So that being said, the last thing it could be is a water pump. At least that's the last thing that I can think it'd be. So I need to go over, grab that 4520 John Deere. I'll just pull the whole auger back too and start changing the water pump because it gets way too hot. When you're running the tractor, by the time you empty a truck, it is getting close to being in the red. And that's not even hardly pushing that auger to its full capacity. So we need to address that and get that fixed. Now, one thing I did check just in case, and guys have told us on the comments before, we read them, we can't respond to all of them, but if the head gasket is leaking, it's gonna start using compression from the engine and shoving it into your cooling system, which is gonna add bubbles into your radiator. So if you have a head gasket that's bad and it's doing that, you'll cause heating problems. And then what it does is it starts creating air pockets inside the block of the engine and it can't circulate the water very well and you'll have issues. I took the radiator cap off, checked it, no bubbles. So I think the head gasket's okay, but we just put water in it. So I can do something really special like, ooh, that's gonna be hot. Oh yeah, just like this. Open that baby up. And let's drain the block. Get that thing completely empty. And this one right here. That's a tad bit rusty. When we cleaned the block and the radiator, a lot of junk came out and it came out clear. But I think now with it running again, it's able to clean out more junk. So I'm gonna let that drain. Completely gone, so that way I can take the wonderful water pump off that doesn't seem to be working correctly. And yeah, but I'm gonna go eat first because it's noon and I'd rather have that thing empty before I come back and work on it. And don't worry, we have a drain in the floor. It'll be fine for now. I'll come back later and this whole shop will be underneath water, but you know what? That's the risk of my decisions. Right? Okay, food time. All right, after the lunch break, I feel pleasantly full. And I'm gonna grab this water pump and confirm, at least try to evaluate that it is the right one. So, we'll pull it out of the box. And so we got a tube. Yeah, that looks about right. One gasket, two gasket, some piece of paper. And here we go. Okay. So, it looks about right. I think we have a match. All right, let's pull the hood off and let's start taking that water pump apart on this thing and swapping it. I got that water pump off. It is slightly different. I thought it was just gonna be a bolt and play because every research thing that I did on the internet They said, this one's compatible, which I think it is. I truly think it is. But the problem I'm dealing with is the shaft here is a lot taller on the new one than it is on the old existing one. The old existing one has a smaller diameter. This has a bigger diameter. The older existing one used this block to space it out, and then you've got your pulley that goes over that, and then it's spaced correctly. Because this one's taller, I think what they did, and you John Deere guys that know this very well can tell me if that is the way it is or not, but I'm pretty sure this inside diameter is the correct inside diameter for this. So I'm hoping I can just take it over the press and press that thing right down on it, and I hope it'll be tight enough where it won't want to work itself off and tear up the radiator. The only way to find out is I got to take it over the press and I got to push it on there. And when I do that, I need to remove this back cover right here. So that way, when I press on it, I want to press on the shaft on this side and press it on this side. So that way I'm not pushing the cover and bending anything and tearing that seal up. So we'll remove this cover, go over, put it on, and hopefully that's what they did. And now to make sure I get the depth correctly, so that way it's not off center, because the problem is if your belts on the engine are running, you want all the pulleys to be perfectly centered. If it's offset just a little bit, it's gonna pull that belt at an angle, it'll wear the belt incorrectly, and what you can have happen is the belt will just pop off and then you'll start overheating and the water pump won't be turning and your alternator won't be turning and your belts get wrapped around the crankshaft and then you gotta find new belts. So I made a little, I just measured, and that's the depth that I need. Just know that I'm doing something somewhat right, so I hope. Okay, let's take this cover off and go press it on, because that's the thing I need to do. Now that water pump is just cast. They didn't paint it. That is the responsibility of the individual that bought it. So, do we have any John Deere green? Not really see any, but I do have this. That'll work. Just messing with you guys. We'll use black. And for kicks and giggles, let's crack this thing open and see what kind of damage was occurring inside. Might not see much, or we could see that, oh yeah, it's done. Yep, it's gone. So what happened with this is it looks like the vanes that are on this little pulley here are all wore down. So between the housing and the vanes, they've got a nice little gap about yay big. And so it was just cavitating. What I mean by cavitating is the water wasn't able to go where it needs to. So it's just swirling in the same spot. And then it starts to get heat. And then what that heat happens is it starts to boil. So the water's boiling, and then that heat and boiling action starts to wear down the little vanes that they have. And then it just keeps going and going, and pretty soon it's toast. Which is amazing to me, because they have a little thing called a weep hole. If you look, there's a hole right here. And that hole will start to leak when the seal starts to go bad. So if it was really getting that hot, or if the bearing was getting bad, which it's not, this one's pretty good, it'll start to leak at it, and then you know, like, okay, we need to take that apart and fix it. But it was just cavitating, and just finally wasn't pumping water. So that is what I would say the culprit looks like. And it's really hard to see, but it's got a nice curled edge to it. I'll try to get in closer and let you guys see.
So it's got a moon shape. It curls down like this. So these veins right here, and that's not a whole lot of flow, really. That's not a very big, it's not a very big gap if you look at it.
If I had to guess, that's our problem. Okay, now I just gotta wait until that water pump housing dries, and then I can throw it back on the tractor and see what happens. Now, I need to wait until that water pump dries because it's all nice and sticky and tacky from all that paint I put on it. And I might as well take this opportunity to talk to you guys about something. If you guys have not, or you'd like to, we do have swag, like this one, says B-Spine, and my wife designed it. In fact, she designed all the shirts and hats and all the cool designs and all that stuff, and she goes on her computer and draws and stuff, and I'm just like, cool, I can't do that. But if you'd like to, you're more than welcome to go and pick out some stuff. She does a fantastic job.
What, just look at it. Just look at it.
Is it gonna be faster?
Oh man, agility boost, over 9,000. Nick, just, it's over 9,000.
Nice. Are we gonna paint it?
No! No.
Guess not. He's doing something funky. I don't know what he's up
to. Sadly, this water pump is slightly different, but I'm making it work.
It said it was compatible for 4520.
Oh, it is now. Can't take it back.
He's unmodified. But it'll pump a lot of water. And we're pretty sure this is the problem that we've been having with this thing overheating. Because we gotta get this tractor going. Because, well, there's, you know, this thing that's attached to it. No, those aren't our pickups, if you're wondering in the background. That's all the adjusters. We literally have like five crop adjusters out here working on the farm. There's a lot of acres, guys. A lot of acres got hailed, so they have got a lot of acres to cover. Anyways, we've been getting rain on and off the last few days, and we just haven't been able to spring wheat harvest. But we've also been kind of up against the green bridge. Not bridge, green layer, I guess. The crops are just ripe to the point where they're about ready. In fact, there's one I think is ready right over here. And it might still have a little bit of moisture from last night's rain, but I think I can go at it. So let's fire this girl up. Beast Bine. Soon to be at the Farm Progress Show if we finish harvesting time. Grab it, it's LSWs, and let's hit the field. All right, but before I forget, I gotta remember one thing. Notice the pile of grain on the ground right here? Yeah, see, I was smart and I left the auger access door open so that if it rained like half inch, it wouldn't fill the tank full of water, because that's already happened once. And when it fills full of water, it leaks into this gearbox right here, and then it messes it up, and then you gotta drain the oil and put new oil in it. So this time I left it open, but I remembered to close that door, because if I don't close that door, I'm gonna dump everything on the ground that I harvest, and then I'll feel really stupid.
So that's where you have to make the decision. Why am I harvesting this field? I'll tell you what, I thought this was better than this area. I think one of the recent storms that hit hailed this out, because when we were here a week ago, it didn't look like this. I mean, I've had zero bushels an acre for like the whole 15 minutes I've been on this side. So I'm jumping to the other side.
Fancying the van trout. Okay, let me figure out what that is and bend it back.
Ooh, fun. What did I do wrong?
Found it. It's all fixed. Okay. Oh yeah. That sounds better than a little scraping sound. Thing is not a clean burning diesel. Whew. But it's good. It's gonna work.
Hi.
What? Who are you talking to?
Hi.
Who are you talking to? It's almost his birthday. He's gonna be how old? How old are you gonna be?
Two.
Three. You're gonna be three. That's five. Three. There you go. We get closer. He's gonna be three tomorrow. So we gotta stop combining and go birthday in here in a little bit.
You best not overheat now. You hear me?
Yeah, we have an understanding. It's all cool. We're friends.
Now, Nick's out cutting right now.
And my dad is with the hail adjusters, taking care of all the hailed ground. And then I was fixing the tractor. So it's about time for me to go help Nick out and chop away at a few acres.
I've been going at this for 2 hours now, and I'm still not full. It's getting there, but nope. 2 hours later, and I'm still not full. It's okay, I got Clifford in the field now. Leg Arms took that combine out, so we got two going. So we'll get this knocked out pretty quick, but we're leaving some strips for the hail adjusters to come and take care of this too. But it's nice to get this done now because there's some big rain coming this weekend and it could set us back a few days. So, get as many acres cut as we can at the moment.